Hello everyone, this is Jason. This video is going to be about immigration. I don't understand why Trump is doing this all of a sudden, this immigration thing, and I don't understand why people are supporting it. If people feel like, I originally thought, I made a video about this, that I originally assumed that people were so anti-Mexican immigrant, a lot of these working class people, because they assumed that their jobs were taken away, or they saw, you know, the blame the other thing. I work in construction, I work in the plumbing, I work in with my hands, and I'm watching my labor being devalued because of people coming through the southern border. Okay, there's also a thing, it seems to be left out, but there's also the visa programs. I think it was the N1 visa that you can come in. I know some people that have on a visa program. They'll bring in, you know, 20-year-olds or whatever, 19, and they have to pay $3,000 to get into the country to a third party, and then a percentage of what they make, and they come work for the summers or whatever, you know, whatever. The problem is not the person coming into the country with getting the job. The problem is the corporation and the governments that don't protect these people, that don't give them a $15 minimum wage, that allow third parties to exploit them essentially for free labor or for very cheap labor. You can pay them less per hour. You get a percentage of what they make. It's incredible, some of these programs to get over to the United States. I thought that's what the problem was, but now I'm hearing words like culture. Now let's be real clear here, and this is going to piss some white people off, and I could really care less. I'm white, right? Look at me, I'm white. White as fuck. You couldn't get much more whiter than me. 6'3", tall white guy from Alaska, right? I don't belong here. My family originated in Germany, Ireland, Great Britain, because I just had a DNA test done. And I think I have some French in there. I don't belong in North America. This is not my continent. Mexicans belong here. They were on this continent. Indigenous people, Indians, they belong here. I don't. My people came over here after the conquest of this country by the British and others, after Manifest Destiny, after the elimination of the Indians, and during slavery. My family essentially about the 1700s, 1800s, something like that. And they were farmers. They didn't own slaves. They lived in Nebraska and other places, and they were farmers. They were poor, dirty fuck as poor as fuck farmers. And they just came over for a better life. Like 99% of the immigrants that came over here, they just were here for trying to come in for a better life. It's the same now. What's the difference of my family coming over here in the 1800s and a family in 2017 coming over here to try to find a better life for themselves? Why am I accepted? Why is it acceptable that my family did it because of a time situation? Well, if we take any measure of time for 100 years, let's say 200 years, whatever, it's not even that much, considering how the earth develops and forms, and consider how evolution or whatever you want to call it. 100, 200 years is nothing. Absolutely nothing for a nation to be. We're 300 years old. We're a young country. But 200 years is nothing. And so now you're not allowed to be an immigrant in America? Now you're not. Now it's, hey, I got here, my family's here, but fuck all the rest of you. No, it shouldn't work like that, because my family came over here a better life. It doesn't matter when it was. I have no family that fought in the Revolutionary War. I don't have one family member that killed any British people. I don't have the Civil War. I don't even know if we were here for the Civil War. I cannot even, I haven't traced it back far enough, but I don't even think I had family members that fought in World War I and World War II, Vietnam, etc. But my family is not from here. So what is the difference of somebody coming to a country that they're not from here? Why would you want to eliminate them? Because they don't have a piece of paper that says they're a citizen? Do you know what immigrants do for us? Do you know how much better they make our society? Do you know how much better Mexican people make? They're into family and community. They start businesses. They are warm, wonderful, kind people. As a group, as a nation, as most people are, as most groups are, most people as a whole are good people. They want to come over here because they want a better life for their families. They want to escape the neoliberal policies that have engulfed Mexico through the IMF and World Banks. They want to be able to watch their kids go to college. They want to be able to have the American dream. And it's a wonderful thing, and we should be welcoming them in. We need immigration reform in this sense. Everybody needs to be given amnesty. We need to have a simpler process to, instead of making people go through the desert with, what are they called? Coyotes or whatever they are that bring the Mexican over here, or anybody from a South American or Central American country from the southern borders. We should eliminate that. And we should walk up to the border. Here's a piece of paper. Here's a voucher for where you can live. We're going to get you a job. We're going to get you into our social fabric. We're going to fold you in, and we're going to make you an American citizen so you can buy a house and pay property taxes. So you can go to work, and you can make enough money to pay taxes and to the social programs that you're going to inevitably need because you live in America. How could you make $10 an hour and not need social programs? Who could make $10 an hour and afford, or minimum wage, and afford to go to a hospital or and pay cash? Of course you would need Medicaid and Medicare. Hell, if you make $20 an hour, you need Medicaid and Medicare, some subsidy. I mean, if you get a serious injury, who has $20,000? Who has $5,000 just laying around? That wouldn't affect them in another way. It wouldn't affect another bill you're paying or whatever. I mean, I rolled my ankle. Didn't even sprain it. I just rolled it, and it cost me $750. I mean, fucking ridiculous. It was a few years back. I hurt my hand. It cost $600 and some just for a fucking x-ray. I mean, it's just absurd. And of course you would need social programs, especially if you come from another country and you don't make that much an hour. So they should be using them. But then what do you do? Instead of raising the minimum wage to $15 an hour so you can get more tax revenue, instead of trying to get them into the housing, I'm here in Nevada still. I'm here for a couple more days. And there are so many empty houses and so many places that need people to live and take care of. Give it to these people. Give them the opportunity. And then they can pay taxes. You give them a cheap mortgage and they can pay property taxes and contribute to society. And that's what they want to do anyway. None of them don't want to. Nobody from Mexico, none of these people that you see over here crossing the border are coming here to be drug dealers. They don't want to be drug dealers. They don't want to commit crimes. They want jobs. Give them jobs. Just put some. That's it. That's that simple. Give them a place to live. Give them some, and make them start to pay taxes. Make them citizens, and non-citizens pay taxes, by the way, too. You can hire a non-citizen. They just have to go through the paperwork, and they just have to go through the process. But you can hire somebody that's a non-citizen while they're going through the process, and they will pay, you know, they pay taxes as well. But make them a citizen. Make them a full-blown citizen. I didn't earn my citizenship. I was born in this motherfucker. My parents had me. My great-great-great-great-great-whatevers didn't earn being here. They didn't have to go through some bullshit rigmarole. They just came. And that's what it should be all over the world. I mean, I think I'm all for open borders. I think borders are ridiculous. But then you get into the economics of it, and you still need to maintain your sovereignty. I've made this analogy many times. Greece, the only reason Greece is in the situation it's in is because it doesn't have its own sovereignty, so it can't print its own way out of the debt they're in. So you need to maintain sovereignty also as a leverage. If every country does the same thing, and again, when I said I'm for one world government, I'm for more of it in theory than in practice, because in practice it would entail, you know, the level of inequality that is coming from globalization is staggering. And it's not a globalization that's built on socialism. It's a globalization built on capitalism. And that's really the problem. So when I see these people bashing immigrants and talking about and using the word culture, your white culture is golf, is Jay Leno, and is, no, I'm kidding. But your white culture is what exactly? Hockey? What are you trying to preserve exactly, homie? What white culture is so fantastic that you need to preserve it, that you're so concerned? Is it you're just a racist? You don't want brown people around? You don't like people speaking not English? Good example of like I said, I'm a liberal, and I'm a socialist. I'm a communist. I'm whateverist you want me to be. That's on the left side. Whatever you want to call me, great, I am. And a great story I watched. It's a heartwarming story, and I'll leave you with this. I was working at a place, and a woman comes in, and she spoke no English at all. And we couldn't even communicate. She didn't come in just to, you know, ask for directions. She needed a product that we were selling, and I could not help her. And I was at the front end, and I said, "Look," and I tried everything. I gave her a piece of paper. I didn't have my cell phone on me at the time, and usually we had a couple of people that spoke Spanish, so it was very, you know, we could always, and we didn't get very many Spanish people in Alaska that didn't speak English, but she spoke none. There was a woman that came up behind her, a white woman, an older white woman, and said, "I just wish these people would learn our language." Really mean. And I'm like, oh, fuck this idiot. Then, I swear to God, not 30 seconds later, she happens to turn her head to look at the woman standing there, and the woman's almost in tears. The woman speaking in Spanish, and she's on her cell phone, and she obviously needs something, and none of us can help her, and none of us can figure out how to help her because none of us speak the language. And this woman, who 30 seconds earlier said, "I wish they would just learn our language," grabs the woman by her arm, right, and says, "I will help you. I will help you," and starts walking around the store trying to find any person who spoke Spanish. That was It almost brought me to tears. It was so enlightening. This woman in 30s had never met another human being. It was all an intellectual exercise. They don't speak, but she saw the need, the pain, the suffering on that human being's face, and spent the next 5 minutes, 10 minutes, and she walked around the entire place and found somebody who spoke Spanish. And they became friends. And that's what this country should have strived to be. That's what we all should try to be, human. Instead of letting money and corporations and political parties and rich people tell us the stories, we should be telling our stories about who we are as people. We should not pay attention to a rich man's history, because if you're honest with television, movies, books, etc., media, it's all a rich man's story. The rich man has the money to get the information out there, the disinformation or whatever, and it only benefits them. And when people take it one-on-one, when people take human to human, there is no boundaries. There are no borders. There are no languages. There's just humans in fucking need. And it escapes me how people can be cruel to other people from other countries. Cruel to people who come here. They're not wealthy. They're poor. They're coming here for a better life because the International Monetary Fund and World Bank has destroyed Mexico, has destroyed many of the Latin countries, neoliberal policies. They're moving from the left to the right as well in many of these South American countries because of populism. They need somebody to do something. They need somebody outside the system like Donald Trump who is honest, they think, and is telling the truth, is going to speak truth to the power that's been fucking them over. So a lot of these leftist countries are moving a little bit more to the right. And it's a shame. That's a real shame. But it's to be expected when the left continues the neoliberalism policies, the left continues to tout how great the IMF is, tout how great debt is, the World Bank, bad trade deals, NAFTA, GATT, world trade, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So you can see why people want the left to go the fuck away, because the left has done nothing to really protect the people. And when they don't, then they're going to the right. And when the right doesn't do anything to protect people, they'll go right back to the left. It's this game that gets bad. It's like it's a fucking volley. And instead of all that, and I think human beings hopefully are moving out because of the internet and becoming a more technologically advanced society. We don't need leaders and rulers as much as we used to. I'm hoping people can really see the absolute necessity for us to join as human beings to fight the powerful. The workers must unite from Mexico, from Guatemala, from Chile, from Texas to Colorado to Boston to New York to Ontario to California to Alaska to China to Japan to Turkey to Hungary to the Middle Eastern countries to the United Arab Emirates Dubai to fucking Yemen. I can keep going to the African nations. We all the workers of the world need to unite and take down those who want to create division and separation in our country so they don't have to take responsibility for the shit that they've put us in. And I know a lot of you want to give me the human condition argument, and this is humans, Jason. No, it's not. It's a certain class and a group of people who have had power for hundreds of years, and they continue to through families, through oligarchs, etc. One of the great tricks that is played on in America is that there is no entrenched oligarchies here, and there is no families that run everything. That somehow everybody's equal in this country, and that it's not like Europe. It's not like these other countries who have entrenched oligarch families. America has the same fucking thing. We just don't use titles like Baron or Duke or Duchess, and most of them are military families who have been, et cetera, and generals. I mean, we don't even know the basic truth about who runs us. And it's not a grand conspiracy. They're not on high. They're all around us. And they continue to fuck us over every day. And then we continue to let CNN, MSNBC, Fox News, the New York Times, et cetera, lie to us. And we continue to accept, they don't mention class warfare. They don't mention that the reason people commit crimes is because they're fucking broke, because they can't get jobs, because the economic policies don't benefit the workers. But we can't talk about that. God fucking did. We have that honest discussion. No, we need to keep making it about the other. Well, if those Mexicans would just leave, then all of our wages would go. How would that work exactly? Well, the illegal immigrants are here that are a danger to society. They're drug dealers and gang members. No, they're not. Well, then we need to eliminate them because our culture needs to be protected. What fucking culture? America is the most devoid culture. Why do you think we... Have you been to Las Vegas? Have you been to Disneyland? There's no culture in America. It's a 300-year-old European colony. There's nothing here. We ripped off... the English language is a good example. It didn't originate in America, but forms of it did. And it rips off everybody else. But it rips off everyone wholeheartedly. We don't have... Our culture is not our culture. It doesn't mean anything. That's a meaningless term. You don't like people of color? Fuck it. Say it. Have some fucking balls. I don't like people of color. Say it, motherfuckers. I personally love people of color. I fucking love Mexican people. The best people that I've met in Las Vegas are the local areas that are these communities that are just like amazing. They're all Mexican. We went to a Mexican restaurant. We're the only people there the other night. No one spoke English. They're playing Mexican music and everybody was fucking nice. Smiled at us, little kids, adults, men, everyone. Warm, kind, decent, hardworking, family-oriented, good people. Just like my people, just like your people, just like good people. And we need to stop these fake border shit. And we need to stop. Conservatives, wake up. Seriously, stop hating for hate's sake. Stop letting rich people make you hateful. Stop. Start thinking about why in 69 million people had to leave their countries or homes last year. Start to ask those questions. Don't say, like Donald Trump and his Sweden bullshit. Watching a Jewish filmmaker who used alternative facts to talk about the horrific affliction of refugees and Muslims coming into European countries and destroying Europe and sweeping across Europe like some plague. The reason those 69 million people were taken away from their homes or had to flee was because of wars created by the West. That's the truth. That's the fucking truth. That's it. That's the truth. Suicide bombers. There's been books written about suicide bombers. The reason they suicide bomb, the reason you become a terrorist is because of foreign occupation. How do you fight an F-22 Raptor? How the fuck do you fight a tank? Or a surface-to-air missile? Can you afford a surface-to-air? You got a couple million bucks sitting around? What would you do? It would be an act of terrorism. It's what our founding fathers did. Our founding fathers. It's how the state of Israel was established, was through terrorism. It's how anything has to be done when you're fighting the system. When you're fighting and you're trying to not niche something out. Our founding fathers, what did the FBI guy say? Our founding fathers would be considered terrorists now? So this idea that the other is to blame, it's not. The corporations are to blame. Rich people are to blame. They are the problem. I'm not talking about people own a small business that makes $1 million a year that's built this work for the last 40 or 50 years, and they appreciate their employees mostly. Very few small businesses get away with being total monsters. They appreciate their employees. I talked to a guy here in town, and he owns a business. He's a white guy, and he employs 30 or 40 Spanish people, essentially, because he has a large – his customers are Spanish, so he needs to have them speak Spanish. And he hires white people too, but they must be bilingual or whatever. And he said he loves their culture. He loves them. He takes care of them. They all love him. I mean, all the employees – I talked to like 10 or 15 employees. Small businessmen in America, small business owners, is not who I'm talking to. You are not who I'm talking to. I know I grew up in a family full of small businesses. I mean, both my parents own small businesses. I've been around real small business. Not somebody who employs, 25,000 people is not a small business. And conflating small businesses with corporations or pretending one is the same. Corporations are to blame. The ones that bring over those kids on those visas and then hire them at minimum wage. The ones that bring in illegal immigrants and hire them at lower wages and don't help them or give them opportunity and exploit them. The guy Pudzer, who was the head of Arby's and Hardee's, and it was going to be the labor secretary, but he withdrew. He didn't pay taxes on his household worker. The taxes were something so small that it was, I mean, how much could they have been? 12 grand? This guy's worth hundreds of millions of dollars, almost $1 billion, and he doesn't pay the taxes on his own worker in his own house who was doing work for him, cleaning his toilets, taking care of his children, mowing his lawns, doing all the fucking shit, all the shit work. And he doesn't have to pay taxes. Fuck him. They're illegal. I'm not going to pay taxes on this person. What kind of cruel sickness is that? What kind of a person does that, that isn't poor? If you're poor and you're not paying taxes, I can accept. If you're rich and not paying taxes, you're just a piece of shit. And our society, you know, rich people don't want to pay taxes. Rich people want everything privatized because they don't need all the social programs. Well, I need the social programs. You need the social programs. Our older, our elderly, our disabled, our disenfranchised need those social programs. Stop blaming the other. Stop allowing yourself to be diverted. Go after the power structure. Go after the Koch brothers. Go after every CEO. You know, if I don't advocate violence. Violence is terrible. Violence is not going. I mean, I'm a Marxist, so violence is a part of Marx's. Go read War and Revolution. But I wouldn't advocate violence. But if you want to be violent against another, you should start treating the other like CEOs and board of directors. They're the other. You want to hate somebody? They're the other. Rich people are the other. Hate them. They're the other. Start thinking in class warfare and economic warfare instead of color of skin fucking warfare or immigration dumb shit warfare. Don't let the power structure who's lied to you over and over and over and over and over and over again continue to do it and tell you that Mexicans are to blame. And by the way, the majority of our immigration now isn't even Mexicans anymore or Spanish people. No, no, no. It's fucking Asian. The majority of people who are staying past their visas and are here, quote, illegally, are Asian descent. Go look this shit up. I just looked that up. I just found out that stat. I was stunned. Is anybody talking about them? Do they have to create sanctuary cities? No. It's a hatred of the Mexican, the Spanish, the southern border. Why? You don't like Spanish? What is the problem? Their culture is vibrant and beautiful. They are socialists. And maybe that's why. Maybe they come from a country and they are more leftist. They think the government should have more. They're not from a culture of right-wing nutcases like a history of Ronald Reagan and trying to tell how great Reaganomics was fucking terrible for this country. And yes, Glenn, I do remember Ronald Reagan. You maybe don't because you're a little bit older and probably made a lot of money. I had friends who grew up in the Bronx and Brooklyn during the Reagan era. My parents, Alaska, we had to move out of the state of Alaska because of Reaganomics. And I'm a white guy in an oil state. Ronald Reagan was an evil prick. He didn't do anything for anybody's economy. He put us in more debt, built up the military, and he's one of the reasons he set the foundation for all those neoliberal policies that people like George Bush and Bill Clinton adopted. So fucking with the Reagan love enough. Thank you. Go fucking do some actual research. Secondly, when you decide that you're going to pretend that the economy of the United States was ever good in the last 30 years for the working class people, it's been a steady decrease since Reaganomics. Reaganomics jumped all of this neoliberalism off. He put us into debts that were, and didn't do it social. He cut social programs and put us into debt through the military. Hi, I'm from what was Reagan's thing? The seven scariest words. Hi, I'm here from the government. I'm from the government and I'm here to help. How is that person good? Why are we electing, or even you bringing up anybody, bringing up somebody who's anti-government to run government? It's like saying, "Hey, I'm anti burgers and fries, so make me the CEO of McDonald's." Does that make sense? Small government. If you don't want to be part of government, then don't fucking run for it and try to destabilize it through your bullshit agenda that nobody knows because you've hatched it inside of a secret room with 30 or 40 other billionaires. Or 20 other, you know, people in power, to eliminate social programs, to cut taxes, and you think that's going to generate jobs? The idealized version of America for most conservatives is the 1950s, and guess why the 1950s were so great? FDR's tax, go look at what you were paying people that made over the equivalent to $250,000 a year. Look what they were paying in taxes back in the 50s, okay? Look what the economies of Russia, the economies of England, Germany, France were all destroyed. There was nobody else in the world but America. And we had all the money. We hadn't been attacked. We weren't rebuilding our country. So we started factorization. We started selling washers and dryers and cars and mass producing this different shit. And that's why the 1950s are loved by the conservatives. Not because of conservative fucking policies. There was no conservative policies back in the 1950s. None. We were still feeling the effects of World War II and of the great FDR and his great tax changing the 94% tax to rich people. And then it started to dwindle, and it's been cut back and cut back and cut back since. That's why we are where we are. Rich people should be paying. You shouldn't be able to make over $250,000 in America a year. That should be a cap. And everything after you make after that is 100% taxable. That's how socialist I am. How socialist are you? You want to maintain? You want to keep? You want to keep your nice house? Then you better raise your taxes, because eventually this shit's all going to go away, and you're going to be blamed. I'm not even talking to any rich people. No rich people watch my channel, but you're going to be blamed. Like I get blamed. I'm the white guy. I'm a big, tall white guy. You think people don't look at me as part of the problem or a Trump supporter? They don't know me. I don't wear a shirt that says I'm a liberal. I have no tattoos. I don't wear earrings. I'm not alternative on any level. Look at me. I look like Rick fucking Perry. I mean, seriously, I do. My sister thinks I look like Rick Perry in these glasses. People fucking think I'm part of the problem. And I'm more liberal than most people that come from other countries about this country. And I think it's common sense, because I've lived through neoconservatism. I've lived through neoliberalism. I've lived through Reaganomics, Bushonomics, Clintonomics, Obamanomics. I've lived through it all. Now I'm seeing Trumponomics. I've lived through the bastardization of communists, making communists the worst thing. When I was a kid, I used to hear there were movies made virtually every month about how Russia was going to nuke the United States. And now we know that was all propaganda and lie, because the Russians weren't even concerned about us. They were trying to get their shit together economically. The Berlin Wall falls down and the CIA didn't even know about it. The CIA really had no idea. The military had no idea. There was never a threat. It was to distract you from the people that are the real threat. The military-industrial complex, the right wing, the conservatives, business-first agenda. Blame the government, not the people who are actually putting you in the economic strife that you're in. Blaming politicians instead of blaming CEOs. This is what the conservatives have done in this country. And it's been going on since Nixon. But the Reagan era just notched it up. And Reagan's approval ratings have been dying every year. In 2000, Ronald Reagan was by one of the top five most popular presidents. And I think he was like number three or something in some of these polls. He's gone way down because people have understood that Reagan's policies were detrimental to America. They only benefited a small handful of people. Small, small, small handful. And any workers that benefited from it, all of those gains were taken away with Reaganomics, or Bushonomics, and Clintonomics. So, and they were all set down because of trickle-down, because of that goddamn awful trickle-down economics, that voodoo economics, as Bush called it, which they all adopted. That was Reagan. That was when that's the 80s. The 80s were a terrible fucking time for inner cities. They were a terrible time for the majority, and it set a new standard of, I mean, compared to the 70s, a new standard of low in this country when it concerned economics. Sure, it benefited the upper middle classes or the middle classes. They always benefit. And throw in the fact that he upped the military spending put us into debt. I mean, massive debt just spending on the military, which was a huge, huge boondock, which is a huge benefit, hugely made. All of these districts all over the country that were only manufacturing weapons made them a lot of money. But it destroyed places like Brooklyn. He abandoned the inner cities. He abandoned, and then throw in the AIDS crisis. I don't know if any of you motherfuckers remember the AIDS crisis when Ronald Reagan ignored AIDS, completely ignored it, and then finally admitted that AIDS, because it was affecting mostly black people and gays. So he just completely ignored it. It wasn't affecting his base. And only until Republicans or conservatives started, all these faggy conservatives who, you know, these closeted homosexual conservatives started to get AIDS or started to get sick, then he started taking it seriously. Oh, well, maybe, you know, shit. Oh, shit. Rock Hudson has AIDS? Oh, shit. You know, all these people that nobody, you know, the social plight, because it was affecting minorities that didn't pay in, it's evil. And so, and I digressed a little bit from what I was saying, but because somebody said something about Reagan, it just pissed me off. But the point is here that immigration is a wonderful thing for this country. We should all welcome immigrants in. We should all embrace it. We should all try to find friends who are not like us so we learn more about the world. We should all travel outside of our borders. We should all try to be working for a one-world government that takes care of the people first. A one-world government based on socialism, not capitalism. That's really the goal. Thank you for listening. And remember, we're all human beings. We're all people. And we're all just trying. It's what Kennedy said. We're all human. We all value our children's future. And we all breathe the same air. Thank you for listening.